Welcome to once again, that is the second part of our fiber and fabrics. Okay students, so in our last video we have discussed about how the cotton in cotton plants are cultivated. Now we are going to discuss how the jute will be cultivated. Jute is also example of a natural fiber, and wool is also natural example of natural fiber. Jute and cotton is the example of plant fiber, where wool and silk is the example of animal fiber. Clear all? So if the question will be asked in the exam, write the names of some plant fiber. So you can write over there with the definition, the fiber which is obtained from only from the plant is known as a plant fiber. And with example you can write the cotton and jute. Clear all? Flax is also, we can say, one kind of plants, but you can write for the no problem. Next, if the question is asked in your exam, what are the animal fibers? So you can write the answer of this question. The fiber which is obtained from only animal is known as the animal fiber. So what are the animal fibers? Example, example of animal fiber is a silk and silk fiber, and second one is wool. Shortly I have to explain about the how can be obtained from the wool. Students, by the way, you will learn in 7th class, but in this class you have to also only know about the wool fibers. The wool is also one kind of fiber. Usually it is wear, we have used wear in a winter season, because the wool is protect from the winter, or we can say from the air. Clear all? It is also thick fiber, and the sweaters, mufflers, this kind of things also made up by the wools. Wool is obtained generally from the goat, then sheep, clear, rabbit, etc. And camel, some of the camel also. Clear. Some animals which were lived in a old region, that we can say that their fur and their fleece of the other animals is also used for making of that wool fibers. Another thing is silk fiber. Silk is a very costly fiber and a very attractive cloth. Clear? Sometimes some people always use the wear the silk fibers. And the silk fiber is made from the silk worm. Clear? And the silk worm will be make a cocoon around their body. From their cocoons, the people, or we can say that the people will harvest the cocoons, and that will convert into fiber, and that make a silk fiber. Clear all? So that is the general thing about the cotton. We can say that the plant fiber and animal fiber. Now here we have discussed about the jute fiber. The jute, actually the jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute. Second thing, it is a cultivated during the rainy season. Clear? Not in the other season, only it is cultivated in the rainy season. Then in India, the jute is mainly grown in a West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. Now another thing is that the jute plant is normally harvested when it is a flowering stage, because when it is flowering stage, there the bark of that jute is a present on the stem of the plant. On the flowering stage, because it is a base stage for the harvesting the good quality of we can say that jute, that's why we have to harvest it in the flowering stage. Now next thing is that the stem of the harvested plants are immersed in water for a few days. One question is arising in the morning, ki sir, why we have to immerse that in our water? Because when we have to immerse in the water, so by which we can easily pull out the that stem of that, or we can say that the bark of that plant, that's why we have to immerse. If it is a dry, it is break again and again, that's why we cannot. It means the convenience is there, ki how we have to take out or we have to separate the jute. The next thing is that the stem of the harvested plants are immersed water for a few days, then the stem rod of fibers are separated by hand, not by machine. It is harvested by hands. Then now, what is the spinning? The spinning means process of making yarn from the fiber is called spine. How can this spine be practical? I have to explain. First of all, you have to pinch the cotton fibers by your one finger and by your thumb. Then another by four fingers you have to pull out that cotton and twist it again and again. If you are twisted again and again, then you will be made a spine. So that process is known as spine. That is also done by our hands, or that is also done by some muscles. Next thing is that a simple thumb. Which type of device are used for the spining? So a simple device used for the spining is hand spindle, and that hand spindle is also known as the Duffy, and another device is a charkha. Students, you are also very well familiar with the charkha. Charkha was used by the Mahatma Gandhi for the independence of our India. Now next thing is that how can we convert yarn into the fabric? So there are many ways by which fabrics are made from yarn. The main two processes are, first one is weaving and second one is knitting. What is weaving? In the weaving, the process of arranging two sets of yarn together to make a fabric is called a weaving. A simple thing is here, students, you have to take any pages. And how can you understand the weaving process is there? If you have made a different type of strips of any paper, so what we have to do, we have to take different type of strips, and in these strips, what will happen? You have to arrange these strips like that, and one strip is arranged into the another just like that. So you have to make just like that a which type of things? Weaving. Now, next thing is that is a knitting. Sometimes at your home you have also seen that your mothers or your grandmothers also knitting something or knitting for sweaters for you. Clear? So knitting means a simple thing is there is a two we can say that the sewing needles is there. By the sewing needles, the women's are also used to making our knitting. Knitting is a simple process there for arranging of yarn. A single yarn is used to the make piece of fabric. Now, the last topic of this thing is that the history of clothing material. Students, do you know the early ancient people which type of cloths were used to wearing? They people were used to wearing of bark, big leaves of trees, animal skin and fur to cover themselves. Because at that time no invention of any kind of stitching machine, no invention of any kind of factories, no any kind of modern process over this. Their peoples are generally used to the bark, big leaves of trees, animal skins, fur and cover themselves. Now then, after peoples begin to settle in the agriculture communities, means when they know about the agriculture, so slowly communities, they learn to the weave twigs and the grass. First of all, they learn to weave twigs and grass. They are starting to weaving the twigs of trees and the grass, and then first of all they make the mats, not directly cloths. They first of all start to learn how we have to arrange the grass or twigs of trees, and first of all they convert the twigs into the basket as well as the mat for sitting. From there they got the idea, if we are arranging the twigs and the we can say that the grass, so why we cannot convert the cotton fibers and some other fibers to make our fabrics. So from there they got idea. Another thing is that the ancient people these were woven in the fabrics. Then after the ancient time in our India, the cotton plants are cultivated in the river or in the near of the river Ganga starting time. Then after some flax is also kind of plant, and the flax were also cultivated that time in the ancient Egypt. Now another thing is that the cotton as well as flax, both plants were cultivated in the river Nile. So the early person from there, they slowly they start to know how can we weaving and how can we arrange the that fibers and that convert into the fabrics. Then early people also don't know, there were no any kind of stitching machine, there is no any kind of stitching needles. So slowly slowly they have to invented the stitching needles also. By the stitching needles they have to arrange different type of cloths and they got their body, and slowly slowly they are invention again and again happened, and finally we have to invented a different type of stitching machines, and nowadays we are wearing a different cloths. Clear all? So that is the history of our clothing materials. So which things, what we have learned from this chapter, in a short I have explained. First of all, the name of fiber, the name of chapter is the fiber and fabric. So in fiber and fabric we have to learn about that. We learn in this chapter what is fiber, how many types of fiber is there. There are two types of fiber, natural fiber is there, then another one is a artificial or synthetic fiber is there. The natural fibers are also two types, that is a plant fiber and second one is animal fibers. What are the example of plant fiber? Cotton and jute, that is the example of plant fiber. Now what are the example of animal fiber? That is wool and the silk fiber. Now next thing is that, now we have learned about what is the cotton, how we have to get cultivated, how we have cultivated the cotton, where it is cultivated, what is cotton bulk, how it is harvested, how it is converted. Next thing is what is jute, where it is cultivated in our India, in which state it is cultivated, how it is the separating out the jutes. So different things we have to learn about this chapter. Clear all? Then next thing is that, how, what is the spinning process, which device is used for the spinning, that is important questions, what is spinning and which device is used for the spinning. Then after, how can we convert yarn into fibers, how many methods are there. So there are two important processes are there, that is weaving and the knitting. Now for information, nowadays many more machines, a number of machines are invented for the weaving and the knitting. And another thing is that is the history of clothing materials. Clear? So in this way, this chapter is over. Thank you so much.